What's up, everybody? Before I get into this interview, I want to thank Drew for taking some time out with me and Josh. Secondly, I want to let you know we got cut off kinda at the end because Google Hangouts is shit in a bed lately. Our Scott Shelby interview, it actually cut out all the video of Scott. You just get the audio. And in this interview, the audio was lagging big time behind the video, so I cut and put together what actually looks halfway decent. Secondly, in between Drew answering, there's slight video footage. This is footage from his actual audition tapes that he sent to Warbeast. So stick around to the end. I'm going to play the one I cut up and put in the interview in its entirety at the very end. And I'm also going to put the link for two other ones he has in the description. So without further ado, here's Drew Shoup from Warbeast. He's a bad motherfucker.
You're watching Josh's Metal Fucking Monday.
Grade, my dad took me to go see Van Halen, and that's what kickstarted. And it was with David Lee Roth, which was awesome, but it was crazy. And then, so that was like eighth grade, and then I got really into Buckethead. You know Buckethead?
Oh yeah,
yeah. I'm still into it. We just saw him the other day at the House of Blues with Scott and Lyric.
Nice.
He's insane. Yeah, this is his first show. Or his first tour in like 4 years, so. But he's a huge influence, and he was awesome. It's insane. I mean, I looked up to all of them. I still do, to all of these guys. And it was.
That's awesome.
All their other bands and stuff. And it's still surreal. I keep saying that, but it is surreal. Like, we're recording an album, it's crazy. No, but Lyric kind of gets it a little bit.
Oh, he does?
Yeah. Lyric's only 19.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so.
Oh, wow, man.
Blue was That's... the youngest for a long time, and then... And then Lyric now is the youngest.
Oh, cool, man.
He's played in some other bands locally, but he's an awesome bass player. It was pretty surreal. Yeah, so that picture, that was last July. It was a year ago, almost exactly. And I think it was around Scott's birthday. I think it was his birthday was that show. And it was a Gas Monkey Live here in Dallas. There's two Gas Monkeys. There's an outdoor one and then a big one, which is the one we played. And it was King Parrot, Child Bite, War Beast, and Super Joint. And that was my first time. That was like my first big show with War. I mean, we had played like around Fort Worth and Dallas and Shreveport and like did a couple warm-up shows since I joined, and then that show was crazy though. That was the first big show for me. It was insane. Looking over and seeing Phil and everybody watching me was insane. I moved from Colorado, last year. About a year and a half ago, actually. Well, what happened is, I'm from Dallas originally.
Okay.
I was born here. I lived here for the first 10 years of my life, and then I moved to Colorado. But I had always been a fan of War Beast since I was, like, probably 17, and I'm 21 now. But I would, I'd seen him with Down a couple times in Denver, so I liked it a lot, what they were doing. So I went I tried to Blue. Yeah. But anyway, he had he plays with Hank 3, you know?
Yeah.
And he had come to Denver with Hank 3, and I had met him there to give him some edibles and stuff. And we were just talking about it. I mean, we had been talking about me coming to just jam and just try out a little bit. And so I went down for Christmas to see my family down here in Dallas. And so I was like, that'll be a good time to try out. So I just we just jammed for like 2 days, and then I moved down probably 2 weeks later. All right, so I'm in a house now, but the apartment we lived in before this house that I'm in, we were like unpacking some stuff because we had just moved into that apartment, and then we just got one of those, you know, the Ninja blenders.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, they work. They're awesome at what they do, but we're just unpacking and stuff, and it had like shit all over it. From fruit and shit. So we just like, I was trying to wash it off. So I was washing every piece individually. And so I put the blade on the counter next to me, and I had reached over, and the cat had jumped from the right where my hand was, jumped onto the fridge, and then fell back down on my hand. And it just pushed it on. And it happened so fast, I didn't even know what happened. Yeah, we went to the emergency room right after that, and so they could stitch it up because it was all the way down. It almost cut my finger off.
God.
I could see my bone and stuff. But it was weird because they were like at the emergency room, they just stitched it up, and we were supposed to play a show like 10 days later.
Oh.
And they were like, oh, you'll be able to play it. You should be fine. And then I woke up the next day and I couldn't feel it or move it still, and so I went back. And they had given me the number of some hand doctor. So I went to him, and he said I had cut my tendon, like two tendons and all my nerves and stuff.
Oh, fuck.
So, yeah, so he had to go back and put all of it back together. He had to use a cadaver nerve.
Wow.
And I had to do physical therapy for like probably 7 months.
Oh, shit.
Oh, well, I knew they told me they were going to wait and stuff, which was awesome.
Fucking A, man. That's super cool.
I mean, they were really, all of them were supportive, so still are, so it's awesome. But it scared me for a minute because it was, it was probably, I'd only been playing with them for a couple months. And then that happened, and I was like, fuck.
Oh, it was bad.
It did at first, but now it doesn't. I mean, it's still numb in some spots. It's dead in some spots. I can't feel it. But it took me a while to get back into it. But now I can play everything I could before, I think.
Past the inlay.
Oh, my God. That is fucking... Is that carved in there?
Yeah, it's all carved in the wood.
Ooh, dude, that's fucking beautiful.
Yeah, and that's a shout out to Hutchinson Guitars from the UK. The only time I get like nervous is when making sure my stuff works right, my gear.
Yeah.
And once we get into the first song and it sounds good, then it's awesome. European festivals and all those, which would be insane. That Hellfest, and that was like 125,000 people when they played. That'd be a crazy festival to play. Yeah, but I hear those, the Europeans love it, so I'd like to play that at some point.
Nice.
Well, what happened was, is there was, they were, I had heard that Bobby had left, the old guitar player.
Yeah.
And so I was like, this is my chance to try and get in on it. Yeah, so I just asked what they were looking for and which songs they wanted me to learn and shit. So they told me those three to start with. And so I did those, and I sent them the videos to Blue and Scott and stuff and Bruce. And then after that is when Blue came to Denver with Hank 3 because he was playing drums for Hank 3.
Yeah.
And, so that's when we met and kind of talked a little bit more about it and about coming down. And so that was probably November. And then I came down December and we played for the first time. And awesome. Bobby, the old guitar player, he's actually a cool guy and he taught me all of his parts. So a shout out to Bobby for helping me out. Yeah, I mean, it's there's definitely a lot that goes on here that I've noticed. I mean, just like the stories and stuff from people, it goes so far back, and you can just tell that there's a lot of like history in this city or in Dallas-Fort Worth. But I know there's a lot that goes on in like Houston and stuff. But
nice.
Dallas is a good place to be, I think. Yeah, we played this place last year in Midland, Texas, which is like west Texas, like far west. It's like 5 hours from here, like 4 or 5 hours, and it was like in the middle of nowhere, this venue. It was cool. It's just cool getting like a different, playing all these different venues. We've recorded a demo already that's done, and Phil's got that and everything, and already said his opinions and stuff. So, but we're going to his house at the end of this month. Not really at the moment. I mean, we have a demo, but that's just kind of a reference for us and stuff. But, I mean, we could write some right now in between now and the studio, and we could write some at the studio, so I don't know. Yeah, I mean, for all of us to get our parts and, like, I mean, we already have our parts, but, like, you know, like, just to get it all ready to go and just have a reference. And, I mean, for me at least, I like having the reference of all the parts and harmonies and shit.
We'll be right back. Pulitzer! Pulitzer!